Here's the Redmi Note 7 Pro, and today we shall look at the camera settings that you need to change before taking different types of picture. Let's say you are taking portraits, you need to change different settings on this Redmi Note 7 Pro so that you get amazing pictures out of it. And if you are capturing landscape, you have different settings to change in order to get the best looking pictures possible from this Redmi Note 7 Pro. Now, in case if this is new to your channel, don't forget to click on the subscribe button. I have made a lot of interesting videos about camera settings, or be it other general mobile photography. So don't forget to click on that subscribe button, hit that like button and share it with your friends as well. So guys, let's look at the Redmi Note 7 Pro's interesting camera settings. So the first setting you need to change is the sharpness. Now, a certain times the sharpness is too much on this phone, on certain times it looks just fantastic. So in order to get perfect sharpness for your pictures, I suggest while you capture portraits, you keep it to low sharpness, and when you are capturing landscape, keep it to normal. Don't change the sharpness to high, because it gets very high noisy as well, the pictures. So that's why just keep it normal when capturing landscape, and while you are capturing portraits, keep it to low setting. The second one is saturation. As you can see, I have set to high. It all depends on your taste. Let's say you are capturing landscape and you have a little bit of sky as well in the picture frame, then you keep it to high, otherwise keep it to normal. If you keep it to low, it just reduces too much saturation. So that's why you either keep it to normal or high. The next one is contrast. As you can see, I have kept it to low. Now, low contrast helps you get that shadows, and even it gives you a sort of matte finish on the pictures. So I suggest you keep it to low. While you are capturing landscape, you can also keep it to high as well. So that way everything just looks deep blacks, look even blacker. So that's the kind of thing changes you will get while you capture with these settings. So this is really important. A lot of people don't tell you and don't know about this setting. So contrast, you may keep it to low, normal or high, and saturation you can keep it to normal or high, and sharpness you can keep it to low or normal, not high. The next one is anti-banding. You change the default 50Hz to 60Hz so that it reduces flicker while you are capturing pictures or shooting videos. And there is this auto exposure settings. As you can see, this is the frame average, center weight, spot metering. Now, when to use spot metering is when you are capturing close-up images. Let's say you are capturing flowers or doing macro stuff or close-up shots, then keep the auto exposure setting to spot metering. That way it enhances the exposure and gives you really sharp images. The second one is center weight. Now, this is for the most situation. Let's say you have people in frame, then you can keep it to center weight. Let's say you are capturing only landscape, there are no persons in the frame, then you keep it to frame average. This is really important. Changing the auto exposure settings will give you very sharp results as well as proper exposed images. That's the key feature that you need to change when you first go to the settings inside your camera. Alright, then there is this volume button function. You can use this volume button function to keep it to shutter countdown, shutter, zoom or volume. Let's say I keep it to zoom. Now what happens is when I open camera and use this volume rocker, as you can see, there is smooth zoom over here. So this is very handy feature. Instead of pinch and zoom, you can use this one while capturing picture or shooting videos. So that's the thing that you can change there. And I always suggest you keep this straighten mode. As you can see, it auto tries to correct whenever you decide on capturing images, so that every single time you get proper straighten images. There is also grid lines here. Again, moving on to the settings, you have show grid lines. So it helps you frame your picture. As you can see, changing the grid lines will show you how your image is going to look. That's why I always suggest in my videos to keep the grid lines every single time. So that's the first thing you need to change, and then take the pictures. You will see a lot of changes in your images. There is also picture quality. Always keep it to high. If you are sharing on let's say Facebook and it's consuming a lot of space, then you can change it to standard or low as well. So again, there is fingerprint shutter over here. As it suggests, using fingerprint scanner, you can actually click the picture. So again, it's a self readable. There is mirror front camera. So if you are getting selfies on the flip side, then you can change it to off. So that way your picture looks just as you would see in your mirror. So this is the thing first you need to change on your camera. Hope this video helps you. Hit that like button if you like this video. I'll be making a lot of interesting videos. Pro mood, manual mood about the Redmi Note 7 Pro is also coming soon. So don't forget to click on that subscribe button. Alright guys, see you all in another one. Till then, take care everyone. Bye bye.